Hi guys, in this example, I'll be presenting how we're going to find, using Pythagoras' theorem, the missing pronumeral right over here, C. Now you might notice that this is a right angle triangle, and the C that we're looking for is actually the longer side, which is also referred to as the hypotenuse. That's right. So let's use the Pythagoras' theorem, or the equation, and that's all about squaring numbers. So the formula actually looks like this: A squared plus B squared equals the longer side here, the hypotenuse, C squared. Okay, now let's take the two shorter sides, which join up here at the right angle, the 3 and the 4, and substitute them into this formula right over here. So let's take the 3 and put it in for the A. So that's going to be 3 squared plus, take the 4, put it into the B. That's 4 squared, and that equals C squared. Let's expand the 3s and the 4s. So 3 squared is going to be 9 plus 4 squared is 16. And that still equals C squared. It is still a square pronumeral. Let's add the 2, the 9 and the 16, and we get 25. So 25 equals the C squared, which is a square pronumeral. We want to get it by itself without being squared, so let's square root both sides. Square root, square root. So the C squared reverts back to just being C, and that equals the long side along here, the hypotenuse equals square root of 25 is 5. Now stay tuned. If you don't understand the square numbers, where they come from and why they're like that, I'm going to show you how Pythagoras' theorem's proof actually looks in pictures. So I'm going to show you some pictures on what these numbers and square numbers represent. So stay tuned, I'm about to show you a picture format.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.